Hello everyone. Today I will cover a pump. This is a section under your hydraulics as well. So under hydraulics we'll have two sections. We'll have press machine and then we'll have pump. So these are two things, and this is one of the most important chapters because it weighs a lot in your final exam. So in this section I will just give a formulas, derive for you a formulas that we'll use for a pumps. And it's very important that you write down the summary for these equations, because most of the equations that are being used under hydraulics are not there on your formula sheet. So you need to just try and memorize them, get used to solve the problems on hydraulics, and then it will make things easier for you. So I'll just do the summary of your equation and formulas, and then I will go straight to the example for EPUB. Then you can go to the other section. Alright, let me try to explain the theory behind your pumps. What you see here, you have many types of a pump. The basic function of a pump is to take your water from your tank to your delivery phase. This section, this is your pipe, and then here you have your liquid. It can be a fluid, any type of a fluid. It can be oil, it can be water. Now, this is a pipe. Your water will be drawn from this tank. It will move through this pipe. This is an indent valve and your outlet valve. Now, this is an example of what is called a reciprocating pump. They call it a reciprocating pump. It has this piston. This is a piston. And then this piston is connected to a cone rod. Now, they call it a reciprocating pump because it has a reciprocal motion. So it moves in up and down. So it has a reciprocal movement. It's moving up and down or forward and backward depending on the position of your pump. Now, as your pump moves up, it draws a liquid from a tank to your cylinder. And then it will be this water which is inside your cylinder, it enters through your inlet via your pipe through your inlet valve. Now, when it goes up, it means your inlet valve is open. When it goes down to push your liquid, your inlet valve is closed, your outlet valve is open, and then it will push your liquid to your delivery phase. So this side, from your surface of your liquid to your inlet of your cylinder, you call it your suction side. And then this side, from your outlet to your delivery phase, you call it your delivery side. Now, the efficiency of your pump, you determine by the maximum vertical distance that your water travels. This distance, you call it your pressure head. So you have a suction head, which is your pressure head on your suction side, then your pressure head on your delivery side. The total distance your water travels is it's called a static head. That is the total vertical distance that your water travels. Now, what moves your pump up and down is this crank. I've just drawn another pump here, which shows you the crank, which is your input of your reciprocal movement. So this crank, you could see that it can move rotary. This is the motion of your crank. So as it moves 360 degrees, it pushes your cone rod. Your cone rod pushes your piston, and then your piston pushes your liquid. So this reciprocal movement is being produced by a rotary movement of your crank. So as your crank moves, it pushes your connecting rod. Your connecting rod pushes your piston. So as it moves from this point to that point, it pushes forward. And then when it moves from this position to that position, it pull it backward. So when it pull it backward, your liquid enters your cylinder. When it pushes, your liquid leaves the cylinder. It pushes the liquid out of the cylinder as well. Now, this is just a theory, and then you won't find many questions under the theory. It's very important to note that this crank is being driven by the motor. So you have a motor as an input of a rotary motion of all this movement. This crank is very important because when you want to know or determine the time it takes for your liquid, you will use your crank. So as it rotates, it produces a rotational frequency. So the number of rotations per second will give you, or the number of revolutions per second will help you determine the time it took for your liquid to move from your tank to your delivery phase. Now let us look at the formulas. The first thing to note at your static head, a maximum vertical distance that your water traveled. So it will be HS is equal to H suction plus H delivery in meters. So this is a suction head, a distance of a suction plus the distance of a delivery, it gives you a static. So I'll just write ST, HST there. That is for your static head. Now, secondly, it's your pressure. Now, what you know about your pressure is that your pressure is force over area in pascals or kilopascals. This equation is still applicable for as long as you do have a force exerted by your piston. But if you don't have a force exerted by the piston, the new equation that oftentimes we use will be rho gh. This rho is your density. Each and every liquid has its own density. So if you are not given a density, you will assume it's water, which is 1000 kg per meter cube. So this is a new equation that you oftentimes use under your pumps, rho gh. Density, gravitational acceleration, and then your static head. You can get a pressure delivered. Now, what is your density? Now, this is a symbol for density, rho. Your density is mass over volume in kg per meter cube. So this is the formula for density. You should always remember the formula for density. Number four would be your volume with the symbol V. You already know the volume. Volume would be area times a length of a piston, the length moved by a piston there, multiplied by C in meter cube. This C represent number of cylinders. Now you can have more than one cylinder. You can have more than one cylinder in series. So if they didn't tell you how many cylinders you will have, you assume you only have one cylinder, but they might give you that the pump with three cylinders or two cylinders. Then you should add that when you calculate your volume. Now let's move on. Now you will have quantity of liquid per second, a volume delivered per second. Now this is where now your crank, you should incorporate your crank, because your crank is in revolution per second. So to be able to calculate the volume delivered per second, it means we have to multiply it by a number of rotational frequencies per second. If it will give you how many liquid it has delivered. Therefore, the symbol that we use here would be Q. Volume of liquid delivered per second will be V N C. This N is your rotational frequency. If they gave you the efficiency, then you want your output, which will be efficiency over 100. But you ignore the efficiency they didn't give you. But if they give you the efficiency, they want your actual liquid delivered per second. Same thing with the volume. If they gave you the efficiency, means they want the actual. This one that you calculate is a theoretical one. You calculated it based on the dimensions of your pump. But the actual one, it's a one after your losses. So it will be efficiency over 100 multiplied by efficiency over 100. Ignore efficiency over 100 if it's not given. But the moment it's given, for your volume, it is efficiency over 100. Now, you will have what is called your work done. with my work done, I'll just use WT. This is an energy major thing, Jules. What you know about your work done is, okay, sorry, here, also add, obviously, this is, since it's measured, sorry about that. Let me just delete this work done. We're going to go to work done right now. This is measured in meter cube per second, since it's a volume delivered per second. Your volume is a meter cube. That means you can also use V over T if you are given time. So if you are given time, you can use a you can calculate a volume using this equation divided by the time in second, if they want it in meter cube per second. But if they want it in a meter cube per minute, then convert your time to minutes and then you calculate. Now, this will be important if you are not given a original frequency, but you need your quantity of liquid delivered per second. Do add this equation, and then sorry for being for omitted it earlier. Let us look at now your work done. Your work done is your energy. What you know about your work done is that work done is force multiplied by a distance. Now, how can you get a force here if you are not given a force exerted by the plunger? That means you must come back. What you know about a force is that your force is mg. Force is mg. So I can change my formula and say mg, and then the distance moved with your static head. So it will be mgh for static head. Now, also now you need a mass of your liquid. How can you get a mass of a liquid? You can change this equation for a density. Density is mass over volume, meaning your mass is density times volume. Instead of a mass, I will write density, then I will write volume, then you have GH. But rho GH is equal to a pressure. So density times gravitational acceleration times H is giving you the pressure. Therefore, the equation for work done will be the pressure multiplied by volume. This is the equation that you derive. So this is the equation that you need to remember in joules. So this was your equation for your work done. It's pressure times volume. But this is how it was derived. General formula for work done is force times distance. This is the one that we find on the formula sheet. But your force is mg. So instead of my force, I write mg. And my distance, it is static head. Now, your mass, it's density times volume, from the formula of a density, and then from there rho gh is equal to a pressure. So your work done is pressure times volume all the time when you're dealing with your pumps in your liquid. You need to remember this equation, and this is how you go to that equation. The last one is power. Your power, it's also P. Don't confuse your power with pressure. So you should just see what you're dealing out with. So your power is measured in the once more, what you know about your power is that power, it's work done over time taken in watts. But your work done is pressure times the volume. Therefore, instead of work done, I'll write pressure and volume over time taken. However, V over T is equal to Q. Therefore, your power is equal to QP in watts. This is the equation that we use for power. And then if they give you the efficiency, they will want a power of a motor, meaning it will be 100 over efficiency. please do remember, this is measured in watts. So this is the equation for your power. This is an equation for your power. Power is a quantity of liquid delivered times pressure times 100 of efficiency, because you want your input power. In your volume, it's efficiency of 100 because you want your output volume. So this is how you should just... Your efficiency will always give you the wrong answers if you disregard your efficiency or if you didn't take note of. Now, let's have to get a summary of our own equation. Summary of the equation that we've done right now. The first one, your static head, it's H suction plus H deliver. Your second one, pressure is force over area. Third one, pressure is rho gh, very important equation. Fourth one, density is mass over volume in kg per meter cube. Fifth one, volume is equal to ahc, number of cylinders, let's see. Sixth one, quantity of liquid delivered, which is VNC, times efficiency over 100. Seventh one, Q will be V, if you are given time, times efficiency over 100. Eighth one, work done is pressure times volume. Ninth one, power is quantity of liquid delivered per second times pressure times 100 over efficiency. That is the 10th one. Now, if you are given your efficiency as a snip, if you are given a snip, that means your efficiency is 100 minus snip. So if they give you the snip, that means they want your efficiency. They want you to put your efficiency. Subtract 100 to get your efficiency, and then you incorporate your efficiency wherever you're supposed to put it, because your snip is a theoretical part minus your actual one. So your snip, if your snip is 20 liters, that means your loss is 20 liters. What is your output? What is your efficiency? That means it's 80. So your snip, you just have to subtract it out of 100. It's supposed to be 100%, but you have a snip of 20%. Your losses is 20%. What is your efficiency? It means it's 80%. Now, what else you should remember, if they want to, is that 1 meter cube is equal to 1,000 liters. They might want your volume in liters. So this is how you have to convert it. So this is just a summary of what we discussed here. From 1 to 11, those are the very important points. These are your equations. Remember your efficiency. Write down and always remember, what should I do with my efficiency? If it's a volume or if it's my power, what is it that I should do with your efficiency? I hope all of you understood. This is a very important theory. Even it's giving you the basics for your fluid mechanics. If you continue to your studies, you will need this background on your fluid mechanics. It's very important there. So you just have to, for any engineering student, this is important. And then particularly for native student, and for, this is a good summary for your hydraulics. And then you could note, once you start your studies, that they don't use the same symbols. They don't have an equation for hydraulics. You do have this equation. Equation number 2 and 3, you do have those ones. 5, you do have. I'm not sure about number 8. But most of the equations, you don't have them. You will check your formula sheet. It's always important to just try and understand, memorize the equations, see how it has been done, and then finally, once you know, and then you know now it's in your mind, you can just write it down as it is. Always select the right equation you use for your problem. If you know all these equations, then it will be easier for you to solve your problem on hydraulics. Thank you for your time. Let us meet on my next video, which is where I would do an example on my palms. And then hopefully, if you did like my video and then you did like the work that I'm doing, please subscribe and then turn on your notifications so that when I upload my next video, you'll be able to see. Also, do recommend to other students this engineering channel. Thanks once more. I will catch you up on my next video where I'm doing an example on palms.